Now, chances are you've already heard of AI and have a basic understanding of what it can do and maybe how it can even help you in your business. And if you haven't heard of AI before, where have you been the last few months? In this video, I'm gonna actually talk about the best practices and tips and tricks on utilizing ChatGPT specifically to help you create ideas and accelerate your content output. So with that said, let's go ahead and jump on the computer and get started. Now, if you've never been to ChatGPT before, this is the main page that you will see when you first enter the site. And at the bottom, you can see there is a little box that says send a message. This is actually where we'll be entering our prompt. Now, one thing I want to let you know before we jump a little bit deeper into this is the quality of your output ultimately is determined by the quality of your input. So it's extremely important that we are very thorough in giving ChatGPT all the information that we possibly can so that the output it gives us is going to be exactly what we're looking for and of high quality. Now, with that said, I'm gonna give you an example right now. So for starters, I'm gonna go ahead and say, give me 3 topics for an email newsletter. Hit enter, and now let's actually see what that returns with. It says sustainable living tips. And then it's really cool because it takes it a step further on its own and gives you a little snippet, a little bit additional context for that text, right? And then the next it says personal development insights. And then the next it's tech trends and innovation. Now you can see this is pretty large and pretty vague in its topics. However, we can actually refine that a bit more. So I'm gonna actually do the same thing. Give me 3 topics for an email newsletter in the photography space. See, now we're honing in just a little bit more. And now we're gonna go ahead and hit enter and let's see what it gives us. It says creative photography techniques. And then it gives you that little snippet of additional context. And then it says gear and equipment reviews. Once again, same thing there. And then it also gives us travel and adventure photography. Now you can see it's a little bit more niche now and gives us more of what we're looking for. Now diving in a little bit deeper to that email newsletter, let's go ahead and actually have it create subject lines for these emails, okay? So let's go ahead and write create 3 email subject lines from those topics. Hit enter and let's go ahead and see what it says. 1, unlock your creative potential. Discover exciting photography techniques. Gear guru, unbased reviews and recommendations for photography equipment. Now you can see it's getting really, really good here, but we can actually take this a step further. So I'm gonna copy our prompt here. I'm gonna paste it down into our chat box here. And let's say create 3 email subject lines from those topics in a friendly tone. And also add emojis if you feel that would help. Now let's go ahead and see what it says. One thing I really like to do is add emojis because it really does help your email stand out from a lot of the other emails that might be in the inbox, okay? Now you can already see this looks drastically different from the results that were just given to us right above. It's a little bit more eye-catching, right? So the first one says, get creative and amaze your friends. Explore photography techniques that wow. And you know, it has those emojis in it and I think this looks really, really cool. So let's go ahead and say we got that all settled down and now let's jump to the next thing. Now let's say we want to create just a bit more content based off of just these 3 subject lines. We can do so and just create a simple blog outline that will help you just kind of get started on your first draft for those blogs. So what I'm going to input here is write me a blog outline for each of the topics above. Hit enter, and now it's going to, within a few seconds, literally just outline and basically almost create an entire blog for you. Look at that. So it's breaking it down. Topic 1, creative photography techniques. And then it goes, introduction, the importance of creativity in photography, how exploring new techniques can enhance your skills, and then technique one, technique two, technique three, technique four, five, and so on. And then it gives you a conclusion to that. And now it keeps going. Topic two, the gear and equipment reviews, and then it gives you the introduction, even camera reviews, lens reviews, tripods and accessories. It really breaks it down for you. Even lighting equipment, that's really, really cool. Now I wanna show you guys a creative prompt that you can use for so many different applications. It's one thing that I use quite a lot actually, and I'm gonna just copy and paste it here and then I'll read it back to you. So it says, write me an Instagram description with emojis. Include a hook and also a call to action. Also include the words, click link in bio. Also include 25 relevant hashtags. All output should be in English. The text would be using AI for marketing. Now, one of these snippets that I think is really important to include is the part where it says 25 relevant hashtags. And I love having this in a prompt for a few reasons. One, even if you don't particularly use those hashtags, you can still use it as inspiration to find other relevant hashtags that might be trending or maybe a little bit more suited to the content that you're actually posting. And then the other reason is if you're using this for an ad, for example, it also serves as a really good inspiration for you to find some other SEO keywords or just really great keywords that you can use to target with. Now with that said, let's go ahead and hit enter and see what it gives us. It says, harnessing the power of AI for marketing. And then there's a few emojis there. It's a little bit more eye-catching. And then it says, ready to take your marketing game to the next level, discover the incredible potential of artificial intelligence and revolutionizing your marketing strategies. And then from there, it also included that part of click link in bio to learn more about the AI-driven marketing techniques that are reshaping the industry. And then below that, it jumps into a lot of the hashtags, right? And that call to action. So right there, it basically gives you a complete ad that you can use, not only for Instagram, you can change that snippet and you can add Twitter, Facebook, really anything you want. You can even swap that Instagram snippet and maybe have it catered more to a particular product that you're trying to sell that you might just need a little bit more content for. Now, as you can see, this is a very powerful prompt and has a wide range of uses. I will actually post this down in the description of this video so that you can quickly copy and paste it and use it for your own application. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to hit that bell notification so you are notified as soon as a new video hits the channel. If you're interested in more tips and tricks like these, go ahead and subscribe to our email newsletter down in the description below. With that said, once again, thanks for watching and I'll see you all in the next one.